These rugged limestone hills in a rift valley east of the Mediterranean Sea have a rich and storied past, from the Bible right up to the present. Different peoples give it different names: Palestine, Judea and Samaria, or more simply, the West Bank, sitting as it does on the western side of the Jordan River. Nearly 3 million people live here, about 2.5 million Palestinians, and more than 400,000 Jewish settlers. It's not large, just twice the size of Rhode Island or Luxembourg, but it has been a central part of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict for decades. June 1967 is a key month. That's when Israel, convinced it faced imminent invasion from its Arab neighbors, launched a series of preemptive strikes. In the short 6-day war that followed, Israel captured land from Syria, Egypt, and Jordan, from which it took the West Bank and East Jerusalem. When the United Nations Security Council convened a few months later, it declared the West Bank, like all the conquered lands, occupied territory. The Israeli army was ordered to withdraw. But there was little inclination to do so. Not only did the land provide Israel with a greatly enhanced sense of security along its eastern flank, it also meant access to holy sites with which the West Bank is richly endowed. In Hebron stands the Cave of the Patriarchs, where Abraham is buried. In Bethlehem, there's Rachel's tomb. Further north, in Nablus, is the tomb of Joseph. These sites, and many more, are holy to Jews, as well as to Christians and Muslims. In control of the West Bank, Israel began building. Homes for Jewish settlers, which became towns, with schools, medical centers, even a university. The population of the settlements grew, from 10,000 in 1979 to 100,000 by 1992 to over 440,000 in 2019. All protected and supported by Israeli soldiers, as well as concrete, barbed wire, and checkpoints. Tensions with the Palestinian population, who felt they were being driven from the land and subjugated, have many times boiled over, producing indelible images still associated with the region: the rock-throwing youth, the carnage of a suicide attack, the devastating power of tanks and attack helicopters. But there have also been attempts at peace and resolution, and the focus has generally been on the same formula: two states for two peoples. The United Nations tried it first in 1947, a partition of the land held by Britain for 3 decades into a Jewish state and an Arab state. The plan fell apart, rejected by Arab powers. The high point of peace efforts came in the 1990s. As part of a negotiated agreement, the Oslo Accords, the West Bank was divided into 3 areas. It was an arrangement only ever meant to be temporary, bridging the way to the establishment of a state of Palestine, also including Gaza and parts of Jerusalem, living side by side with the state of Israel. But it never happened. Legally, little has changed. Most of the international community continues to describe all of the West Bank as occupied territory and says Israel's settlements are illegal. Israel disputes that, saying its rights to the land stretch back to biblical times and the status of the land was unclear when Jordan had it before 1967. Palestinians also lay historical and religious claim to the land, where they still hope, one day, to build their state. The reality is that diplomacy has been in limbo for years. Negotiations, a peace process, seem like ideas from another era.